Westerns better know who is good guy, who is bad guy. So I'll give you two names to provoke you also. Solzhenitsyn versus Varlam Shalamov. Yeah. I almost hate Solzhenitsyn for this verbosity, deep moralizing. If you want to get the raw taste of what Gulag is, read Varlam Shalamov Kolyma Tales. I think it's endlessly superior to this endless moralizing of Solzhenitsyn and so on. So again, do Varlam Shalamov. If you want to get at the roots, the 20s, the potentially, to use your terms, demonic side of the 20s, read the one who is, and it's now more and more recognized among my Russian friends, the greatest Soviet Russian author of the 20th century, Andrei Platonov. His foundation piece and so on. Yes. There you have, he saw the nihilism already before Stalinism, he saw where there is some terrifying nihilistic dimension in it. So I would say these are two of my favorite names in fiction, pure fiction, Andrei Platonov, especially his great novels, but also his short stories. There are some wonderful movies even made on them now, and Varlam Shalamov. I like him deeply, but I'm sorry to tell you this. It will disappoint you. For me, he's way too soft humanist. In his very approach, it's something missing to grasp what you called the truly demoniac side of Stalinism. You cannot do it. He was too kind a man. I will even say this in a way. This is not a criticism, you know. You must have like Platonov, a certain almost madness in yourself to get it. Although, again, I have a great, almost infinite respectful feeling for Vasily Grossman. But the other more interesting point would have been, so here I would agree with you, it's not simply black and white image. Take someone like Sholokhov. Yes, the official Soviet guy, but you know that he nonetheless, in the early 30s, he protested to Stalin against the horrors. He was almost, so you know, you have even almost official big writers who nonetheless had the minimum of honor. So let me end with another provocation. Let's face it. Quietly Flows the Don is a better novel than Dr. Zhivago. Dr. Zhivago is for me not such a great novel. I mean, Pasternak is a wonderful, great poet, whatever you want. You know, one should have the courage to distinguish even among great dissident figures. Like, this is my personal taste, you will probably violently disagree. But for me, Osip Mandelstam and Marina Tsvetaeva are infinitely superior to Anna Akhmatova, who is an endlessly pretentious bitch. She has this complex, I am a mother of all Russia, I speak for all Russia. Fuck you, Mandelstam is my hero.